Hello and welcome to this edition of the Time with Hime podcast. I'm joined by our superintendent, Mr. Hime. How you doing, sir?
Doing good, doing good. Ice storm in October, pre-time change.
Crazy.
Wow, yes.
And we're just back from our two virtual days.
Yes, you know, it's kind of a new experiment for us, obviously. We've never done this before. I've never done it in my career. Lawton hasn't. You know, we have inclement weather and different factors led to those decisions. Even the time change was a factor because of how dark it still is in the morning, because up until this weekend, for those of you who don't remember, the first is when we change, you know, we fall back, so we get an extra hour. But how dark it was, that was part of it. But, yeah, we got to try it. You know, we've talked on this podcast, I mean, all the way back in June, we started talking about how we wouldn't have snow days anymore. They would be virtual days. We'd continue the learning. And we've been working on how we're going to do that and trying to practice. And, hey, finally it happened, and we got to practice. And, you know, for the most part, I think most of the final reviews it went really well. So hats off to our teachers for being flexible. And most of our teachers did a tremendous job for it, and we're really excited of how it went. As everything we talk about, you don't have to be bad to get better. We're going to work really hard to get better at how we did the virtual days, how we interacted with students and parents, and how we can make it smooth. You know, probably one of the biggest complaints I got was multi-children households. It looked really different in different households. Hey, log on to info@lawtonps.org and give us your comments. We're really looking for that because we're really looking at ways to improve how this looked these last 2 days.
Okay, and you talked about some of the feedback that you received. I know some of the questions we had were, what are the expectations on behalf of the parents when we are in a virtual day?
You know, and that's something we want to get consistent. You know, we want the parents, we want learning to continue. We want as much as possible for the students to be able to train our students to be able to do that on their own. But, you know, obviously pre-K, K and 1 students are going to have more help than other students, more oversight. But, you know, we have Go Guardian. We have teachers monitoring, making sure students are not doing things on the web page that they probably shouldn't be doing. So there's a lot for us to learn, you know, and that's the goal. So we want to improve the process. And if parents and students, if things happened and you felt like they were a little bit, our expectations were too high, or you didn't truly understand the expectations, please shoot us that email, get involved in different surveys, let us know so we can improve this process.
The one thing that we were excited about is just like our traditional day where we would be on site, we also had our tech team and our ed tech team available to support both the student and the teachers.
Yeah, one thing we've already talked about in improving it is from now on, we'll put out a hotline so you'll know when you get the announcement that we're going to a virtual day, you should also get a phone number or a contact so you can contact the hotline for virtual help. You know, no matter what you do, especially with an ice day like this, you're going to have some problems that are unforeseen. We had teachers that lost power. Therefore, if the teacher lost power, the teachers couldn't get on and be a part of the virtual. So it became more where the students just had to get on Google Classroom or Seesaw and do the lessons without the teacher interaction. So we had a few of those. We had some students who lost power as well. And, you know, we tried to get it out there. On those things, it's going to be just like being absent from school. You're going to just make it up later and then you're not absent. So there's always going to be some exceptions. But, you know, for the most part, it was 2 days. The weather was nasty. It was raining, wet, icy outside, limbs falling. Kids are stuck in the house. Giving them something to do and some interaction those few days. Most parents were very thankful because it kept their students from just doing nothing for 2 days, and it gave them something to concentrate on and focus on. Again, we want to improve the process. In no means are we saying this is great, but I will tell you one thing once again. Our teachers, they're just the bomb in this deal. From the day one when we started in August on splitting virtual and traditional and all the things we're trying to do and the flexibility and working with our parents, the LPS teachers as a whole have worked really hard to make that work. And it's very difficult because, you know, one thing as a superintendent you always talk about is, you know, we got to make decisions that are best for students, not adults. But the adults are very, very important to us. And our adults have joined into making those great decisions for students. And so it's been super because, again, you know, this flexibility, again, I'll say it again, it's not Kevin Hime being flexible. It's not changed my life. I mean, the COVID has changed my life, but the flexibility of students moving from platform to platform doesn't create work for me. It creates work for teachers and counselors, and they've all joined in to make that work for our parents. So hats off.
And we're very thankful because they did a really good job. And one of the things that was really something that I was excited about to share was the meals that we even offered, because we knew that weather was going to be nasty yesterday morning, and we wanted to still be able to give our students who were at home a hot meal.
And, you know, that's something we're going to work to improve as well, is to making sure that's out there. You know, those are that we're always on icy days. If we can get people up there, or if we're out of school for any reason, we're going to try to get some meals prepared for our students, because we're kind of under that summer feed program where we can feed all the time. So, you know, we're going to look into the possibility of winter breaks and Thanksgiving breaks and Christmas breaks and different long breaks like that. You know, will they let us provide food over that time period? And if they do, you know, we'll work to see if we can't get some people to help provide food during that time as well.
Well, it was much appreciated by the families that came out and enjoyed it. So thank you for making that happen.
Well, I was at home on my computer working in my home office. You know, I didn't get up and prepare the food. Thank you to the cooks.
Yes.
And Daniel, our cafeteria manager, and all the cafeteria managers who went over and above and got to work on those days to prepare the food so people could eat. So those are the ones that need the hats off. I was just the guy.
We have the best staff.
Yeah, we do. It's easy when you're at home and you just type an email or you pick up the phone and call somebody and say, hey, what do y'all think about this? Can we make this work? And you have a great idea. But it's always great to have great ideas when you're not the one who has to carry them out, and those people work hard to carry them out. So I want to give the credit where it's due, and that's to our cafeteria workers and staff who made this work.
And we're talking about, you know, what the great work that they're doing, we can't forget about reminding our parents about our COVID summary. So let's share into what's going on.
Again, one of the issues we have as a district is you get into confidentiality, what you can say and what you can't say, and we still get a little bit of confusion, the difference between isolation and quarantine. Somebody who's isolated is usually that's going to be somebody who's tested positive. Somebody who's quarantined is somebody who's been in close contact. So be sure and check under the community section on the front page, LPS COVID summary. And when you check that COVID summary, you can see the number who has tested positive, the number who has been quarantined, and the active positives are in red. So that's a lot better information than, you know, sometimes somebody will say, man, there were five kids got quarantined out of one, are tested positive out of one class. Everybody should know. No, those five people might have been put in quarantine. And if I'm in quarantine, the people around me don't, that's not something you share information. That's the health department. That's, you know, that's health, you know, your privacy acts and such that you can't do that. You don't have to do that. So we still have to abide by those rules. But understand as a parent, just because three students aren't at school, they're quarantined. If your child was in close contact with somebody who tested positive, not only would the school the health department would contact you. So, you know, we work really hard on that communication, and it's still a struggle we have. I mean, no doubt this has been a work in progress for all of us, and you know, we've used the term before, and different people use it, and you know, it's kind of like building an airplane while you're flying it, and that's a struggle. And again, I've had a lot of it's been a struggle for me on some of it, but again, as we're doing that, the workers getting it done, the teachers and staff have been great. So hats off again.
And for our students that are staff that are quarantined, they still have the ability to continue with their schoolwork.
Yes, and again, that's one thing we've worked hard, you know, is to make sure that we're making that available so they can do their work while at home and get online and log in and be a part of their child's classroom. And, you know, those look different. And that's probably one of the struggles we get with whether you're quarantined, where you're working virtually in a virtual student, or whether it's an inclement weather day that we've turned into a virtual day now instead of having inclement weather. You know, how do those days look? They're just going to be different with different teachers, and we're going to try to make them as uniform as we can. But some teachers have great internet and have good lessons planned, and they're going to be on there for 2 or 3 hours. Some teachers don't have a lot of internet, and so they're going to try to get on there in sporadic times and do it. So hopefully tell us what worked and what didn't work for you, and then we'll try to exasperate what worked, and we'll try to work on the things that didn't work to make them better. Because again, as great as our teachers are and as great as job as they've done the last couple of days, I still stand by, you don't have to be bad to get better, and we're going to get better. We're going to, you know, we said when we started this, we're going to be the best virtual school out there. And so that's a challenge to our teachers, and they're doing a great job, and we're moving in that direction.
And speaking of getting better, we have something coming up in November. I can't believe we're already to November. Wow. It's happening fast. But LPS on the Grow You want to share some things?
Well, again, LPS on the go, it kind of started. It was a way where we could meet with our virtual families or any other family, and we could provide food, resources, and make sure tech help, and just a time where parents could come meet with teachers and staff and different people in our organization to tell us their needs. And again, we're trying to improve that communication. And for those parents who chose virtual for their children, we're trying to make it as normal as we can, because in most cases there were health reasons, different reasons for safety that they chose virtual. So we're trying to make that as normal as we can and continue to make them part of the school, because just because they're learning from home, they're still LPS students. So they're still students of the particular building at some point. So we're excited to grow that, you know, and again, it gives us a chance to provide food. You know, we get that out there more and more to our parents who are virtual. It's just like summer. On Monday, you can pick up 10 meals, and some of those things are just going to keep growing. And so get up there and get it. You know, it's one thing during this pandemic that for lack of a better term, that we're getting paid to provide you those meals. It's not causing the district any problems. So just get your food, and eat it, and we'll enjoy it. And if you need things, call. And we're working on a hotline and some different things. Again, we got the info. We're here for you. You know, I always say that you, the parents, are our customer. Your children are our customers. We have to serve you. And so if you need things, you need to let us know. And those informative emails, those emails just letting me know, I love them. You know, every now and then you get the one email where they're going off on a tangent and they don't even tell you who they are, what school they're from, who their kids are. And you're like, well, I wish I could help them because, I don't get enough information. But so many of the emails I get from parents, and they come through the info, are very informative, and they're making us aware of things we can do better, and we're going to try to do them better. So again, thank you for continuing to communicate with us, and hopefully we're doing our best to meet your needs, and we'll continue to work hard to get better at what we're trying to do.
And just as a reminder to our families, when we come back Monday, Sunday, you are going to fall back on your calendars. So go back
hour.
An hour of
yep.
sleep. That's yes. right. So maybe there'll be some light when the kids are walking to school. But yes. It'll get darker sooner, too.
Yes, no doubt. It's going to get darker sooner, but we will have light. We're excited to, you know, can you believe this weekend's Halloween?
That's right.
You know, how's that going to look with the COVID? I'm sure a lot of people will get out, but make sure you stay safe. And Monday's November. That's still kind of... It's just,
we're ready. It's, 2021.
Yeah. 2021. Yes. Come on. It can't be worse than 2020.
Knock on wood.
Yes. It can't be worse than 2020. But we're getting there, and we're getting better. And, you know, hopefully we get more and more to normalcy. And you know, right now we're wrapping up. We've got football season going on, and all of our football teams make the playoffs because of the new OSSAA rule. And
Cross country.
They're
going to be represented this weekend.
Yep. So we're very excited about all that.
All right, Mr. Hime, is there anything else you want to add before we wind down our time?
No, just again, continue to communicate. We'll continue to communicate with you. Let's work together to make the best of this situation that's not the best. So we appreciate, again, our parents, our family, but most I appreciate our staff, our teachers, and our workers for all they've done to make it. I mean, this is hard on people because it is different. And hats off to you. So thanks again for all you do for us.
And thank you guys for tuning in to our Time with Hime podcast. Until next time, we wish you a safe, warm, and healthy weekend. We'll see you next time.
Happy Halloween.
Bye-bye.